G'day guys, we've got an applications of differentiation question for you today. More specifically, we're doing incremental change or the method of small changes, whichever your teacher is referring to, it doesn't really matter. Now the question is asking us that we've got the time period t for a simple pendulum of length L is given by this particular formula here where g is a constant. Just a little bit of a bonus fact, this g here they're referring to as gravity, which is 9.8-ish meters per second squared on Earth. Now we have to find the percentage change in t when L changes by 6%. Okay, so let's just write down the information that the question is giving us. Let's have a look at our objective function that we've got. We've got t equals 2 pi square root L on square root g. And we're also told that the percentage change in L is 6%. Now the way that we represent percentage change in these particular questions is the incremental change in length over the original length. So the way that we're going to do this is represented by delta L divided by L. And this is equal to 6%, and as a decimal, 6% is 0.06. Cool. And what are we asked to find? We're asked to find the percentage change in T. Okay, so like the percentage change in L, we're going to represent this as delta T divided by T. And that's what the question is asking us to find. Now, the methods of small changes basically says that the change in the dependent variable can be approximated by the derivative of the function evaluated at the original point multiplied by the change in the independent variable. So we're going to exploit this to find the percentage change in t, or delta t on t. So to start with, what we have to do is we have to find the derivative of this initial function. Now, I'm not going to go through the mechanics of finding the derivative. So there are many other videos that I have and that are spread across YouTube on the mechanics of finding derivatives. So we're going to go straight to the derivative of t with respect to L is going to be, so we have dt on dl is equal to pi divided by the square root of g times L. Cool. So now what we're going to do is we're going to enter this into the formula that we've been given or that I provided on the right-hand side here. So the small change in t can be approximated by the derivative of the function times the small change in L. Cool. So from here, guys, what we're going to do is we're going to make the left-hand side look like the arrangement that we're looking for in the question, i.e. the percentage change delta t on t. So to do that, I'm going to divide both of these sides of the equality by t. So I'm going to go divided by t, divided by t. Cool. Now for the right hand side of the equality, I'm going to enter in for t, rather than just writing t, I'm going to put in the function for t that we're given in the question, i.e. 2 pi times square root L on square root g. Because the t is in the denominator on the right hand side, I'm going to multiply all the things that I have in red in this right hand side of this function by the reciprocal of this objective function for t here. Cool. Okay guys, you're not seeing double. I have cut and copied this part down here and altered the square root g times L in the denominator of this first fraction to an equivalent form, square root g times the square root of L. The reason I've done this is just to make the algebra a little bit easier to see as I move forward, I guess. So first of all, we're going to cancel out things that when they're divided by each other, they equal 1. So we've got pi in the numerator here and pi in the denominator there. So those things will cancel out. We've got g in the numerator here and g in the denominator here. So they will cancel out, and these two square root L's will be able to be multiplied together in the denominator. And for those people who don't know or just need a refresher, if I've got two of the same number that are square rooted multiplied together, for example, if I said the square root of 5 times the square root of 5, this is simply just 5. So the square root of L times the square root of L will simply be L. Cool. So let's just go about making this a little bit neater. We've got delta T on T can be approximated by, we've got a 2 left over down the bottom here. So I'm going to stick that out the front and have a half multiplied by delta L over square root of L times square root of L is just L. Cool. Now, from the information we're given in the question, guys, delta L on L is 0.06. So the percentage change in T is going to be approximately 1/2 times 0.06, which is equal to 0.03 or 3%. So there you have it, guys. When the length of a pendulum is changed by 6%, its period, or the time it takes to spin back and forth, will change by 3%. So I hope the video helped, guys. If it did, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel. I put out new videos all the time on maths, science, economics, you name it. I'll try and do a video on it. And if you guys had any problems with any of the content that I put in this video, please don't hesitate to leave them in the comments section below. Alternatively, if you have any questions regarding your maths, physics, economics, chemistry, work that you're doing at school, please don't also hesitate to leave it in the comments section below. I'm always looking for new video ideas. So until then, guys, please keep going over different types of these incremental change problems. The only way that you're going to get better at them is by doing problems over and over and over again. Keep bashing your head against the wall. Eventually that wall will definitely fall down, I promise you. But most of all, whilst you're doing all this work, remember that you must keep enjoying your maths. I'll see you again soon.